I'm blowing down this road, dusty road. I'm a blowing down this old dusty road. I'm a blowing down this old dusty road, Lord, Lord, and I ain't gonna be treated this way. I'm a going where the water tastes like wine. I'm a going where the water tastes like wine. I'm a going where the water tastes like wine, Lord, and I ain't gonna be treated this way. I'm going where the dust storms never blow. I'm going where them dust storms never blow. I'm going where them dust storms never blow, 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 and I ain't gonna be treated this way. They say I'm a dust bowl refugee. Yes, they say I'm a dust bowl refugee. They say I'm a dust bowl refugee, Lord, Lord, but I ain't gonna be treated this way. I'm a looking for a job at honest pay. I'm a looking for a job at honest pay. I'm a looking for a job at honest pay, Lord, Lord, and I ain't gonna be treated this way. My children need three square meals a day. Now my children need three square meals a day. My children need three square meals a day, Lord, and I ain't gonna be treated this way. It takes a $10 shoe to fit my feet. It takes a $10 shoe to fit my feet. It takes a $10 shoe to fit my feet, Lord, Lord, and I ain't gonna be treated this way.
Well, BNY Mellon gave us an ultimatum to either move out or to face eviction. That time has passed. That was at 12 noon today. And we have hundreds and hundreds of volunteers here, as you can see at the top of camp. And what they are doing is preparing for whatever scenario might happen next.
Hi, I'm a nurse here in Pittsburgh, and out of my practice of compassion, I support the movement. Our society has become totally out of control, and we need to change it. We have to move drastically from where we're at to a new place, one that values the environment and every member of our society equally. That's why I'm here today, and I'll be here in the future, and I'm not going away.
Is universal health care a human right?
I certainly feel it is, and not only that, I think that if we had universal health care, it would move us in a direction of social equality. If we based our health care on a straight percentage tax, it would redistribute wealth slowly and steadily, and give us a basic human need that would be should be respected by all people.
Today we're here with Celeste. Celeste is a little preoccupied.
Oh yeah, I got my landscaping groove on. And then I'll like sweep for hours. Yeah, it's very meditative.
No pun intended, she's preoccupied, but she's gonna take a minute out to tell us about Occupy Pittsburgh for the World Wide Web.
Thanks, good buddy Vince. Wow, today is something else. We had a noon deadline to no longer be in this wonderful encampment, and what do? We clean up, we mobilize the community and say that, you know, we're not going anywhere. Yeah, it is serious. Haven't been in situations where I've been actually evicted. It was sad to hear, but we're not afraid. We knew that so many other occupations were forced to leave. Wow, that's wonderful. They're relocating a really nice canopy common area. Yay! Woohoo! So, we're here to stay. We're here to stay.
Hi, I'm just fine. This is a wonderful day. It's wonderful to be at Occupy Pittsburgh with people all working so hard to just have love in this city.
Okay, so you're one of the major issues that you're involved with is fracking.
Oh my gosh, yes, yes, yeah.
And how's that going?
Well, it's not going very well. Talk about corporations, you know, calling all the shots. We're about to get all of our community rights taken away from us. We can no longer zone to plan communities the way that we want to. Well, we can at this moment, but it's fast approaching the time when the state will take those rights away from us as well. It's a scary situation. This week I watched a Democracy Now! And the Climate Change Conference and found that the administration just really isn't interested in keeping our air and water and soil clean. So it's a big, big problem. Corporations have just bought up the world. This movement is about taking it back. So generally speaking, Marcellus Shale is a big one for me. I've been working on it now for 16 months. You know, I just eat and sleep Marcellus Shale and all of the attendant problems. I really worry. We have a well, you know, and we want to retire and stay in Murraysville. And this is a frightening thing for me. I have grandchildren. It's a frightening thing for me. But to tell you the truth, it's frightening to think of everything leaving. I have grandchildren that are in college. They don't even see a future. I mean, I never thought this was going to happen to us, ever. But it's been creeping. We need a complete separation of corporation and state.
Where do you think that, where do you see this movement going?
Well, I think this movement will change. I think we can't just hold on to this little piece of land. I think what we've got to do is inhabit and occupy everything. So I'm hoping that this movement goes into homes, maybe move this from to the city hall initially, and then maybe over to parking lots of churches and stay together for the spring assault. But the whole idea is to stay together and to be able to talk and really communicate all of these ideas and really make a difference, make change. This little piece of property is nice to have now, but we really want the whole world.
Occupy Pittsburgh is now planning for the police invasion. We're going to be prepared. We're going to have layers. We have things that we can't tell. And we're cleaning up the place. They have no reason. It's squeaky clean. People are happy. People are prepared. We're going through it's top secret. But we will have a core and layers of resistance. We've got union support. We've got people on call. We're ready. We're gonna do this in peace and solidarity. We're gonna lock arms. This movement will not stop. If we get pushed here, we're just like Mercury, baby. We're gonna occupy something else.
We shall not be moved.
Hey, comrade.
We shall not be moved.
All together.
Stand up. Okay. Here's a legal support number for people who are arrested. If you have some way of writing this down, it's also at top of camp. I have it written on my arm in permanent ink. 412-465-0269.
What are the last two?
412-465-0269.
The cops deserve a raise.